Our next guest this morning is making the case for betting on Davao and Mindanao in general for investors. Damosa Land President Ricardo Lagdameo joins us live from Davao del Norte, I think, from his farm in Davao del Norte. Carrie, thank you so much for joining us. Great background.
Hi, Mimi. Good morning. Thanks for having me. And good to be back on the show. And good morning to all your viewers.
Of course, you're now the chairman of the Davao Icon, the investor conference for this year,
yes,
right?
That's correct, for this year, yes.
Okay, so I guess let's start with that. How is the business or an investment environment there in Davao? I mean, here in Metro Manila, at least, we're seeing quarantine restrictions because of the COVID-19 surge. How is Davao doing? Are businesses there bullish or bearish, or is everybody on wait and see mode?
Well, you know, Mimi, I think it's really been a mixed bag. There still have been a lot of challenges, just like anywhere else in the country. But just like other parts of the country, we are seeing some signs of resiliency. So, for instance, real estate has been one of the resilient sectors, and certain sectors at that. No? So, for instance, there have been some BPOs that expanded over the pandemic. We also like the agribusiness space because agribusiness and, say, manufacturing, these industries were able to operate even during the pandemic. And as we know, agribusiness is very important to this part of the country. But then you have certain sectors like tourism, obviously, that's still very challenged. SMEs, F&B are still very challenged. But, you know, we're trying to be hopeful. We believe that with a fast vaccination rollout, which is actually pacing quite well, we think that hopefully we'll be able to recover sooner rather than later. We're under a less strict lockdown here than in Metro Manila, so there is a bit more mobility. So at least some industries have been able to continue to operate.
And Carrie, just to note, last year, your economy of Davao contracted just 7.6%. You did a little bit better than the country in general because the Philippine economy contracted at a 9.6% rate. So you guys did a little bit better. Still a contraction, but better. I'm very curious, you did cite some industries, the agribusiness, for example, the real estate, which you know very well because with Damosa Land, you guys are into property. I'm very curious, are there new frontiers? Are there new opportunities for investments there?
Yeah, absolutely, Mimi. And what's good about the region is that unlike, say, you know, years ago or over a decade ago, where the industries were so focused on agribusiness, the focus has really diversified over the last few years. So the services sector has shown more promise, the manufacturing sector. We also like the fact that there are more industrial parks that are being put up. Port infrastructure is very good, so it's an ideal place for manufacturing and for exporting, especially when you're dealing with the ASEAN region, because as you know, Mindanao is the closest in terms of location to the ASEAN region. We also like the BPO space. A lot of experts have been talking about BPOs not necessarily moving out of NCR, but setting up additional facilities outside of NCR. And we already saw that for this year. And the real estate space, what we're seeing is that the projects are getting bigger and bigger. All of the major real estate projects today are essentially townships. And these are from the likes of large public companies. And what that means is it brings about opportunities in the office space, because normally they'll have an office an allocation for office buildings and also for educational institutions. So now we're seeing normally what was Luzon-based educational institutions coming to the Davao region, the likes of Lyceum, Mapua, UP Los Baños will also be putting up a campus in the next few years. And of course, not to forget agribusiness, because it's still very important. Aside now from just our usual exporting of bananas and pineapples. We're starting to see companies actually manufacturing these products into higher value products. And as you probably know, the Davao region is now considered the cacao capital of the Philippines. Mm-hmm. Coconut as well. We have a very high concentration of coconut coconut trees here in the Davao region. So now we hope that there will be more higher value processing for these raw materials. So there's really a very wide range of opportunities that are available in the region.
Good to know that the region is moving up the supply chain where more money is made in the value-adding processing. I'm very curious, Carrie, at a time when companies are scaling back, has Davao region been welcoming new investors over the last 18 months? And if you could cite some new investors who have set up shop?
Well, you know, there have been, right? The truth be told, of course, there are those investors that are still on a wait and see. But the existing investors that are already here, and there's really it's a who's who of the major real estate players, for instance. I mean, Ayala Land, Cebu Land Masters, Mega World, SMDC, their projects continued throughout the pandemic. And these are all mostly township projects. They're multi-billion peso projects. And then we had a number of hospitals that also opened during the pandemic. And these were all large-scale hospitals. We also had a Japanese manufacturing company that completed their facilities or their factory just about 2 months ago, and they will be operating within September and hopefully exporting by October. On the infrastructure side, we see from the private side, companies such as the Aboitiz Group through their Apo Agua project. That's a major bulk water project that was that has been constructed over the last few years. It will be operational by next year. And as we all know, for any investment to be successful, you need an abundance of water. And then you have on the public side, infrastructure spending on things such as the Davao Coastal Road, the upcoming Davao Bypass Road. So at least you see it from both the public and the private side. I think towards the end of this year, we'll probably be announcing that there's going to be a major European manufacturer of sporting goods equipment that will be setting up shop hopefully by first quarter of next year. So that will be another major investment. I think, again, it's a bit of a wait and see, but they're very much poised to come in.
Can you tell us which brand this is?
Not yet. If you have me back on the show by the end of the year, I promise I'll tell you.
Okay, let's book it. We're booking it. It's confirmed. Okay, Carrie, final question. Clearly, there's so many exciting things happening on the investment side for the Davao region. You know, everybody has been looking at Davao for the past 5 years because the president is from that region, President Rodrigo Duterte. And now with elections just around the corner, the next president could also come from the region, the daughter of the incumbent. Does it make a difference? Do you think when the president is from your region that you do get more, you do get prioritized, or the spotlight is on your region? Is there a difference for investors?
Well, look, you know, I think you can't avoid it. The spotlight will obviously be on the region. But what we always like to say is that the strong growth in the Davao region started probably more than 10 years ago. And that was very consistent. You know, leading up to 2016, obviously after 2016, then that continued to remain very robust. So we like to see our investments as long term, and they I guess depending on, or it doesn't how do you say, it can transcend any precedent, whether they're from here or from any other part of the country. It was really the strong fundamentals of the Davao region that really made it what it is today. And during our investment conference on November 11 and 12 of this year, we'll be really highlighting that. We'll be highlighting investments that have been here for decades and showing how they have been successful throughout the years.
Mm-hmm. For more information, you know, we just have to watch out for the conversations at the Davao Icon happening soon. Carrie, thank you so much. We will see you at the end of this year. It's confirmed. For
yes,
the blind item that you shared. Thank you, Carrie. Stay safe.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.